electric vehicles, a car that runs on batteries. They work in lots of different ways. Here's one of them. Take a Tesla. A 300-mile battery pack is made up of 7,000 lithium-ion batteries. Inside the batteries, tiny ions of lithium move from an object called the cathode to the anode. The battery is made up of nickel, cobalt, lithium, and aluminum. This generates a flow of electrons, or electricity. These batteries pack a serious punch. They have a large charge and discharge rate, so they produce a lot of energy, and you can reuse them a lot. To prevent the batteries from overheating, an EV uses a cool liquid that flows between the batteries. Then, an inverter takes this power and changes it to an alternating current. Think of it as a voltage that changes. From there, it produces a rotating magnetic field in the motor, and voila, you have power. The drivetrain distributes that power to the wheels, so you can drive your car. Any electricity that isn't used, like if you slam on your brakes, is sent back to the battery pack. The $36,000 Chevy Bolt goes 238 miles on a charge, and the top-tier Tesla Model S can go 315 miles. After that, you gotta charge it, about 30 minutes at a station and almost a full day if you plug it into your home. The cool part is the battery sits low and flat on the bottom of the car. Think of it like a skateboard. This lower center of gravity helps balance your driving. So, does it all work? Well, the US average cost of gasoline is $2.55 a gallon. It's $1.21 for an electric e-gallon. You save 50%. Now, prices do vary, and the more miles you go, the more expensive the car can be, and prices can range anywhere from $30,000 to $180,000. But the hype is hot, the personalities are big, cars are sleek. Is it worth it?